Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to Exotic Astrology. Nice to see you back again. And a very interesting topic, which somebody asked me recently. I thought it's high time I should make a video on this. And that topic is how to deal with toxic family members, especially parents who, or any elder especially, because it is more difficult to deal with elders in the family if they are toxic, you know, rather than juniors. Okay. So how do you define toxic people, toxic family members who always try to not pull you down exactly, but try to tell you that you would be better if you would follow what they said, you know? So now here there are multiple things to consider. The first thing is the seniors, the elders in our family, they are our well-wishers. There is no doubt. I mean, almost. So therefore, we should never outwardly reject what they say just because we don't like them. Yes, many times we don't like the person who is saying that. And that is why we end up rejecting whatever the person says. That is not good. That is not correct. And then the other thing is, see, there is this triangle. Okay. Whenever in life there is any confusion, this triangle has to be followed. What is that triangle? Oh yeah, and I forgot to say, if you are new to the channel, then please subscribe to it. And I have started making, I am going to start making videos on these playlists also, which I had left, I don't know why. And if you want a consultation from me, you can go down to the website. We will find it down in the description section. And yes, God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and you will find him. So what is that triangle? The triangle is Guru Sadhu Shastra, GSS. What is this triangle? Guru Sadhu Shastra. It means whenever somebody is telling you something, what does it mean when somebody is telling you something? It means that person is temporarily acting like a guru. So what the guru is saying must match with the sadhus and shastras. Otherwise, we should reject the instruction of the guru. Yes, that's very unfortunate, but we got to do that. So for example, suppose one guru comes and tells you, oh yeah, you can eat meat, no problem. You know, it's okay to eat meat. After all, you know, your body needs protein or anything like that. It's required after all, you see. So then suppose the guru comes in, how much ever big he is or she is, and how much of a fan following that person has, that person comes and says, so then what do? We start eating meat, or we continue to eat meat if we are already doing, or we listen to what the sadhus are saying. Sadhus means the other spiritual personalities. Are they also saying the same thing? And then we check the scriptures. Well, is it said that you should eat meat? Where is it? No. Can't kill animals. That's it. Stop. No discussion, no arguments, no debate. We have not given life, so we cannot take life. So similarly, when any family member, any elder, any senior is giving us any advice or any instruction, what can we do? We have to check, is it matching with the sadhus and the shastras? Only then we should accept that information. And who is the most exemplary person in this context of Guru Sadhu Shastra? It is none other than Bali Maharaj himself. If you read the 8th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, if you have not read, please read this pastime, please. Not for God's sake, for your sake. So, in this pastime of Bali Maharaj, the Guru comes and tells Shukracharya, the Guru of Bali Maharaj, the Guru of the demons, the Asuras, comes and informs his most loved disciple, Bali Maharaj, that this young boy who has come like a very innocent child is not that innocent. He is none other than the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Lord Vishnu himself. And now he's being very nice. He's asking you, can you give me 3 steps of land? You fool, don't give him 3 steps. If you give, then you have had it. He will, with one of his legs, he will mark the entire upper planetary systems, and with one, he will mark all the lower, including this. And then you will be imprisoned and you will be thrown out, and your desire to sit in Indra's throne will never, ever, ever be fulfilled in this lifetime. So you'll be miserable. You will lose all your wealth if you give this donation to Vamandev. So this was an instruction which his guru gave. And then what Bali Maharaj thought? Bali Maharaj heard it, no doubt. But then what happened? He started contemplating what the other, what does the other guru say? Well, they are not saying this, because ultimately whatever we have is Lord Vishnu's. He is the ultimate proprietor. Krishna says in Gita, Bhoktaram Yajna Tapasam Sarva Loka Maheshwaram Suridam Sarva Bhutanam Gyatva Mam Shanti Mruchati. One who understands that I am the enjoyer, controller and proprietor of everything, of all the sacrifices. Gyatva mam shantim ruchhati. Surit sarva bhutana means, and also I am the well-wishing friend of everybody. He alone attains peace. Gyatva mam shantim ruchhati. So how is it that we are trying to keep ourselves and not give something to Lord Vishnu? How? That's very stupid, because everything is ultimately his. And then he goes to the scriptures. He quotes from the scriptures. And he says, no, everything that we have is ultimately his. So there is no harm in giving something to him. So Bali Maharaj rejects the instruction of Shukracharya. Why? Because that was not in harmony with the sadhus and the scriptures. That is why his instruction was rejected by Bali Maharaj. And that is why he is one of the 12 Mahajans, as mentioned in the Srimad Bhagavatam. Swayambhu Narada Shambhu Kumaro Kapilo Manu Prahlado Janako Bhishmo Balir Vaya Sakhi Vayam. Yes, Bali, the name is there. He and his forefather Prahlad Maharaj, these two are born in the Asura families, but still they are Mahajans. They set the trend, they set the example, they set the standard. Yes, whenever in doubt, just check the lives of these Mahajans. Everything is crystal clear. So sometimes similarly, we may feel that what our family members are saying is not in accordance with the scriptures and with what the other spiritual personalities are saying. So in that case, we must reject the instruction or that advice which the senior has given. So for example, many times I have many godbrothers from my spiritual community who tells me that, oh, their parents are forcing them to eat meat, or the mother or the father, and then you can't do that. There are sometimes you will have a elder brother or elder sister who will be like, "Hey, chalo, hum pita hai, tumko bhi pilayenge." Yes, there are people like this in the family. You are doing mantras in the morning and then they are sitting and watching TV. What a scene. Alright, so first of all, we have to understand that the family members with whom we are very closely associated, especially mother, father, elder brother, sister, or whoever they are, even husband, wife, children, they are a very close reflection of our past. Our past, not their past. Yes, we must have had that desire to stay with them. Otherwise, we will not take birth in that same family. Take it in writing. Yes, because see, karma is not so random as people think. Oh, you have this in karma, you will get it. No, you must have the desire also. If you never had any desire of that person, how desire means not romantic or sexually, but to be with that person in some way or the other, then how in the universe are you staying? How did you get birth in the same family? It's not possible. Alright, so we have to accept the fact that in some lifetime or in some point of time in our spiritual journey, we had desired to stay with these people for some reason. So now because we have elevated our consciousness spiritually, now we are not able to be in harmony with this person because this person is dragging me down towards matter. And I am trying to elevate my consciousness spiritually. So they can give us clues about our own self. See, by seeing their behavior, you can understand how you were in some lifetime. Wow, very beautiful. Yes, they can tell us how we were. So that can give us a big motivation. That we again don't want to fall back to the mundane standards. Because when we are born in that family, same family, it means that we were also like them once upon a time. So do you want to become like them? No, never. So this should be a big motivation factor actually. And we also have to understand that the karmic dealing which we have with these people is far more intricate than any other stranger, especially with parents and even more with husband and wife. Husband wife is like that is like the highest karmic bondage, good or bad, whatever, it's ultimately a bondage. So therefore we may not be able to wish out these personalities like we have, you know, in keyboard there's a delete button, you know, tit delete. So we may not be able to just delete and throw these people out of our lives, and we should not do that. We don't have to do that. We should respect them from a distance. Never ever ever disrespect them. This is the first and the last thing. If you want to deal with them, the worst way to deal with them is by disrespecting them. Because the moment you disrespect a person, that person becomes hell-bent on trying to prove that he or she is right and you are wrong. And then they will again try to pull you down further. You know, so we must respect them from a distance. That is all that we can do. And the second thing that we can do is we can be very firm in our own spiritual practices. If we are firm, then eventually they will also follow us. Otherwise, if we are only shaky, dawadol, as they say in Hindi, dawadol hone se nahi milega kuch. Tum khud hi gir jaoge. So if you are shaken up yourself internally, if you don't have the courage, that determination to make that thing happen yourself, if you are not ready to sacrifice whatever it takes to achieve that, then they will feel that you are just hovering around on the surface, beating around the bush, because they know you. They have seen that in your childhood or in your past, you have said big things, but you have not done, right? So they know. So sometimes they're also checking by trying to test you. Yes. Are you really committed? Or are you just yourself? The same old you which they knew. or which they know. They always know you in and out, especially the parents or the husband and the wife. And the next thing that we can do is do our duties properly. Duty means if you are a husband, then take care of your wife. If you are a wife, take care of the husband. If you are a father, take care of your children. If you are a son or a daughter, take care of your father, mother, mother-in-law, father-in-law. If you are doing your duty properly, then half of the problem is solved. Our problem is when we have some disagreement with the family members, what we try to do, the first thing we do is we disrespect them. And second blunder we do is, which is even worse, is we compromise on our duties. In fact, there are people I know who has had some terrible quarrel with their parents, and on the birthday of their parents or on the wedding anniversary of their parents, they don't even call their parents. My God. That's the worst thing you can do. If you do that, then they will become even more toxic. All right. So if you do, because see, everybody is wanting, see, relationship is basically give and take. Okay. Whichever relationship it is. So everybody is actually wanting something from you. Whatever it is monetary or financial, emotional, physical, sexual, or whatever it is. But if we do not give what they want, then give in the sense according to our duty. So suppose you have your parents, then you must take care of your parents. Yes, as a child, you should do that. So when they are getting that love and care and affection from you at a human level, then they will be able to appreciate you more. Okay. And the last thing that you can do is pray for them. That is all that you can do. And I know now many of you will say, oh, I have done all this. It has still not worked. I can't stay with them. Blah, blah, blah. This, that. That is why I said in the beginning, the karma with the intimate family members is very strongly linked. It's very intricate. Krishna says in the Gita, Gahana karma no gati. So you can only be firm. First is you should always respect them. Never disrespect. Whatever, how much ever they are shouting, you should never shout. Never ever ever do that mistake. I know it's very difficult, you will be tempted. I am also tempted. But if you have done it in the past, then it's, you can't change it. But in the future, never ever ever shout or disrespect them. Never challenge their authority. You may not follow what they are saying, you may not like what they are saying or what they are doing, but that doesn't mean you have to disrespect somebody. You can not like somebody and still not hate the person. It's possible. Even the great souls, like, they've said always that, you know, hate the disease, not one who has the disease. Don't hate the patient. All right, so never disrespect them, always respect them. Then second is be firm in your own principles and your commitment and your duties, either material or spiritual. Prove it to them. Show them the results. Don't tell them your plan. Show them the results. Then they will understand what you are saying. Yes. And then next is you have to do your duty properly. If you are a brother, you have another brother. You have duties as a brother. As a sister, you have duties. As a husband, as a wife. That you have to do perfectly. Or at least the other person should feel you are trying to do it perfectly, even if you are not able to do. And lastly, you can pray for them. And even after that, if things don't change, what should we do? We should accept it as a part of our karma. It might seem very pessimistic when I say this, but actually it is empowering. You know that this is my karma, I have to face it. I have tried everything. That is what the scriptures say. Try, do your best. But even after that, if it doesn't happen, accept it as a part of your karma. Because you have tried everything. If you have tried all this properly, not superficially, then you have tried everything. And even after that, if they are not understanding you, they don't change. Of course, people never change, but at least they should not hinder your progress. That is something which people can do at least. Then it's best for us to accept it as a part of our karma. Okay. Otherwise, it's not very good to, you know, superficially go and insult them. And if things are very bad, then you may not stay together. That's fine. But never, ever, ever disrespect them. Never do that. Never blaspheme them. Never say bad things on their back. Never, ever do that. Backbiting. Never. Kabhi nahi. Never. Always respect them and appreciate them from a distance. If that is what time demands from you. Because remember, the close family members, they have done great things for you. Never forget the good things which they have done for you. Either it is your mother or your father or your husband, wife, whoever. So remember, I mean, however bad an individual can be, or however, to whatever extent you may hate the person, but there would have definitely been some incidences where that person would have helped you, that person would have guided you. And if you remember that, then they will also remember when you help them, when you give them love. Because my guru always says, love attracts love. So if you give love, they will also understand love. They will also reciprocate. Alright. And as usual, even after that, if you fail, then accept it as a part of your karma. And don't keep cursing yourself. Don't keep cursing your horoscope. Don't keep cursing your karma. Don't keep cursing them. Don't keep cursing God. Don't do that. Alright. Thank you very much. And if you are new to the channel, then please subscribe to it. And if you want a consultation from me regarding your karma, then you can always go to my website below in the description section. Okay, thank you very much. God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and you will see him. You'll find him.